The ending made no sense. Well, it made sense, but then the movie just ends like, y'all not gonna follow up on some of those threads that establish what happens. How are you doing, everybody? The Bruce, older brother Deconstruction here. And I wanted to talk about my favorite movie of all time. And I am not lying. It's Airborne. You know why this is my favorite movie, but I can watch this movie nonstop over and over again and never get tired of it. But the story is about one Mitchell Guzman, whose parents, well, he's in California, he's a surfer, and a rollerblader, but that comes into play at the end of the movie. We won't really going to talk about that part. His parents are, I forgot their profession, but they have to go to Australia for like 6 months. And he was like, oh shit, I get to surf in Australia. But they're not taking him with them. They sent him to Minnesota to live in the Midwest with his aunt, uncle, and cousin, Wiley, played by Seth Green. The movie also has Jack Black in it. But the thing I want to talk about with this movie is the main conflict of this movie is started by the antagonist. So when Mitchell introduced himself, he says it's a perfect scenario. He lays it all out, has a fucking name for it and everything, and it's about surfing. He doesn't know what he wants to be. He just wants to live near a beach, so on and so forth.
What about the new kid, Mr. Colley?
Yes.
Yeah, I think it's his turn. Okay, Mitchell. Mitchell Guzin, at your service. I'm not from around here.
Hey.
What do you tell? Well, I don't have any stories. Don't know what I want to be when I grow. Don't care. Just as long as I live near the beach and don't have to wear a tie. Then, I'll be styling.
Styling? What? What? Styling?
Let me tell you what styling is. The perfect session. A-frame wave, ground swell, spitting out salt water in your face, doing a little lip action move, a 360 without a bounce. I call it a liquid Drano, wannabe Bullwinkle. I tell you no lie, my friends. It's a consciousness raiser.
His cousin Wiley talks about he's a hockey man, his dad drives a Zamboni, so on and so forth, and he's like pumping himself up to play hockey.
That's all I do. I mean, hockey is my life. I've got on hockey underwear right now. I have a hockey toothbrush. My dad drives a Zamboni. He gave me a puck.
Oh, boy.
Cycling puck. What about
Augie, Jack Black's character, pushes him out of the way. Then they talk about the game against the Preps. And they're not really organized. They like, don't even have a fucking team uniform or practice uniform or something. There's two twins that are dressed alike in a hockey uniform or hockey jerseys, but they're like the only one coordinating.
I have a few things to say. Could I add something, please? I think that the pretty boy Maharishi over here has been mixing a little bit of Drano with his fruit punch.
You tell him, Augie.
I mean, does anyone here believe this L.A. laid-back horse poo! This guy is peddling? I don't buy it. You big fruity two-shoe.
Whoa, the old hiney hairs are wound a little too tight on that one, eh, dude?
What'd you say? What'd you say?
I just said, what a fine public speaker Augie was.
Yeah, I bet you did. Pretty boy. Surfer.
All right, Jack. You could be next.
You don't really think surfing is a sport, do you? It's not. Mm-mm. It's badminton, man. It's checkers. It's getting a suntan. You want to try a real sport? Why don't you try hockey? As a matter of fact, man, we got a game today against the Preps.
Right.
We've never beaten the Preps. And I'm not graduating in May a loser. We're nobody's doormat. We're going to do it today. We're going to kick the Preps' butt.
So this one guy volunteers. But here comes the kicker, which bothers me about this movie. Somebody, like two players get like suspended or something. So they get Wiley to fill in. He was like, what? No. And then so he's on the the ice with him, and he's playing, and then he gets knocked the fuck out. So Mitchell goes to check on Wiley, and Snake says that California here should fill in for him. Now, and everybody agrees. Everybody sees that as a great idea on a team.
Great, man. Now we're man short. Fine, we're playing with five.
Oh, man. I think California here deserves a shot.
All right. Gear up, surfer.
A guy who doesn't play hockey knows nothing about hockey, and you're like, this is a smart idea because we want to beat the preps. He states, we have a game today. We want to beat the preps. And then he was like, yeah, let's have Mitchell do it. And he's like, okay. So I'm sitting there thinking, like, why would you knowingly put someone who doesn't play hockey on a rink? So Mitchell scores in the wrong goal. Thought he was doing, like, you know, he helped out. And the bullying starts. Like, they blame him for their loss. But they don't blame Snake. They don't take accountability for it. They put a man who doesn't play hockey, who serves on the ice, scores against him. Now they're bullying him throughout the movie. Like, so he has, like, this... So, Jake, like, goes on the ice and then he knocks him down and basically said, you're dead. You cost us the game. No, nigga, I'm sorry. You cost yourselves the game by agreeing that that was a great idea. Sure, you needed one person. You didn't tell him what to do. You didn't give him any type of advice. Hey, I'm going to score on my own team. This is on you. I still love this movie, though. Don't get me wrong. The ending.
That's the wrong goal.
I'm sorry, man.
Sorry, man? You cost us the game.
Surfer's got salt water in the rain. California.
Great shot.
This, the entire thing, like the breaking apart to leading to the adventure coming together of this movie is one of the flimsiest I've ever seen. And I just wanted to talk about that. This is going to be a relatively short video, but I was watching it and then I was like, wait, why are they mad at Mitchell when he doesn't know how to play hockey and they put him on the team? Now, yes, I've said it about a thousand times in this video, but this is just sitting on me like, why? But I do love this movie and I highly suggest you should check it out. I think it's hit cult classics levels, and I know people who rollerblade love this movie. I don't rollerblade, but I love this movie. So with that being said, I just wanted to get something quick out because I've moved a video game over to Twitch, and I haven't actually done a video in like a year, so I just wanted to get this out there. This is the older brother, Deconstruction of Bruce. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.